Hello, my dear students. In this lecture, we are going to see one previous year GATE numerical, which was asked in previous year 8, that is 2017, for 1 mark in set 1. Now, basically, this question is asked to find LMTD of a condenser. So, let us understand the question. The question is, saturated steam at 100 degrees Celsius condenses on the outside of a tube. Now, my dear students, the saturated steam at 100 degrees Celsius is condenses. Condenses means there will be a phase change, and this condensation is nothing but conversion of steam into liquid. Therefore, this steam will become water. But my dear students, during phase change, temperature will not change. And in condenser, the hot fluid undergoes phase change. Means here steam will undergo phase change, and this steam is a hot fluid. So as they have mentioned here, condenser. So let us draw here condenser. Now, my dear students, again in theory lectures we have seen that for phase change, if one of the fluid is undergoing phase change, it may be a hot fluid as like in condenser, or it may be a cold fluid also as like in evaporator. Right? Whenever there is a phase change, then the parallel flow becomes equal to counter flow. Parallel flow heat exchanger always becomes equal to counter flow heat exchanger. Right? Therefore, here whether you are using parallel flow or whether you are using counter flow, the answer will be same. So if you want to consider parallel, consider parallel. If you want to consider counter flow, then consider counter flow. Don't worry about that, because here one of the fluid is undergoing phase change, and for phase change, for counter flow and parallel flow, all the calculations are same. So don't worry about that. So let us draw here a diagram. Here I am considering parallel. Let us consider parallel. You can consider counter also. Right now, and you have to do this, consider counter and solve the question. Right now, my dear students, for parallel flow heat exchanger, the entry of cold and hot fluid will be on same side. Let us say this is the entry of hot fluid, left side, THI, and here temperature of hot fluid will not change. There will be a phase change of hot fluid. Here hot fluid is steam, therefore there will be a phase change of steam, and the temperature of hot fluid, that is THI and THO, will be same. Right. And here they have mentioned the saturated steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Therefore, temperature of hot fluid, that is, I can say THI is equal to THO is equal to 100 degrees Celsius. Then, on the outside of the tube. Now, and let us say here entry of cold fluid, TCI, and the temperature of cold fluid will go on increasing. Therefore, here there is a cold fluid, right? And here exit temperature of cold fluid, TCO, right? Now, the cold enters the tube at 20 degrees Celsius and exit at 50 degrees Celsius. Therefore, here entry temperature of cold fluid, which is TCI, is given 20 degrees Celsius. Entry temperature of cold fluid is given 20 degrees Celsius. Here enters at 20 degrees Celsius and exit at 50 degrees Celsius, means the exit temperature of cold fluid, TCO, is given 50 degrees Celsius. Now then, question is, the value of log mean temperature difference, LMTD, is in degrees Celsius. Now, question is to find LMTD, that is delta TM, which is nothing but log mean temperature difference. We have to find in degrees Celsius. Right. Now, my dear students, we know that this left side temperature difference we are calling as delta T1. This is delta T1. And this right side temperature difference we are calling as delta T2. Right. Therefore, here can I say delta T1? Delta T1 will be left side temperature difference, that is THI minus TCI. THI minus TCI, which is equal to THI is nothing but 100, TCI is 20, 100 minus 20, which is 80 degrees Celsius. And right side temperature difference, delta T2, which is nothing but THO minus TCO. Therefore, THO minus TCO, which is equal to THO is again 100, TCO is 50, 100 minus 50, which is 50 degrees Celsius. And we know that the LMTD formula, this LMTD, which is also called delta TM, is nothing but delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by ln of delta T1 divided by delta T2. This formula we have derived in theory lectures. So let us use this formula to find LMTD. Therefore, here LMTD will be equal to delta T1, we have calculated 80, minus delta T2 is 50 divided by ln of 80 divided by 50. So let us solve for LMTD. Right? Therefore, LMTD for this question will be equal to 63.8 2 degree Celsius, right? So my dear students, here in the fill in the blanks, you have to type here 63.83 for getting 1 mark, right? Now my dear students, for the same question, if I consider counter flow, let us solve this question by considering counter flow, right? With the help of parallel flow, we have seen LMTD value. If some student consider it as a counter flow, then we will check what will be the answer, right? Now for counter flow, the entry and exit of the hot and cold fluid will be from opposite side. Let us say here, if I draw counter flow, let us say the left side is entry for hot, therefore THI, right? And hot fluid temperature remains constant, therefore THO, right? THO here. Now, and hot fluid is flowing from left to right. And for counter flow heat exchanger, if I assume counter direction, then the cold fluid will flow from right to left, and the entry will be cold fluid TCI, and exit of cold fluid is TCO, right? Therefore, now this left side temperature difference is called delta T1. Left side temperature difference is delta T1, and right side temperature difference is delta T2. Now here, definition of delta T1 and delta T2 will change as compared to parallel flow. Now here, delta T1 will be equal to THI minus TCO, which is equal to THI is 100 minus TCO is 50, which is equal to 50 degrees Celsius. And delta T2 will be equal to THO minus TCI, which is equal to 100 minus 20, which is equal to 80 degrees Celsius. Therefore, let us use here this LMTD formula. Therefore, in this LMTD formula, delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by ln of delta T1 divided by delta T2. Delta T1 is 50. Delta T2 is minus 80 divided by ln of 50 divided by 80. Again, if you solve by considering this, you will get same answer, that is 63.82 degrees Celsius, right? So don't worry about type of heat exchanger for if one of the fluid is undergoing phase change, right? Because my dear students, here we can write delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by ln of delta T2, ln of delta T1 divided by delta T2 is always equal to delta T2 minus delta T1 divided by ln of delta T2 divided by delta T1. This is always equal, and this is called log mean. This is a log mean, right? This is a log mean. And my dear students, as it is a log mean, therefore it is for temperature. Therefore, the temperature is called log mean temperature difference. Temperature is called log mean temperature difference. Thank you, dear students. In next lecture, we will see one more numerical on this topic, which was asked in previous year GATE examination.